Welcome to the Writer's Rendezvous from the South Dakota Humanities Council.
Hello, I'm Carl Gerke of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. I'm here at the Deadwood Grand for the 2013 South Dakota Festival of Books, and my guest is Margaret Peterson Haddix. She's the author of The Missing series. Margaret, thanks so much for joining us here. I'm wondering how you got started writing for young adults. Was this kind of always what you had in mind, or just something that happened?
Not necessarily. It was kind of how it worked out, that the first couple of books that I wrote fit with young adults, and I've done some that are middle grade, some that are young adults, some that are even for younger kids. It kind of seemed to happen that the ideas that I had seemed to work well as books for teens or kids, but looking back at it now, it really makes sense. In hindsight, I can see a deeper reason to it, which was that when I was 10 to 14 years old, books were so important to me, and so it makes sense that that's the audience that I'm writing for now, too.
So do you go back to when you were 10, 14, and think of, okay, what would I have liked to have read when I was that age?
I kind of do, although it's pretty much also, maybe I just never grew up. That a lot of it is just, if there are ideas that I think are fascinating, I think kids are going to think they're fascinating too.
Well, what's it about the ideas that you write about that make them more appropriate or more aimed for young adults than, say, grown-ups?
An adult audience. Yeah. I guess, you know, there's this huge debate going on, mm-hmm. especially with young adult novels, about what makes something a young adult novel versus a novel for adults. And I don't know that I can weigh in with a terribly good answer on that, but I think that it's from the perspective of the young adult, the teenager, and the focus is on the changes that they're going through rather than something that's going to be more meaningful to an adult, I think.
Is it fun to write characters that are that age, that are at that really strange time in life?
Yeah, absolutely, because things are so vivid at that age. You know, you've got things like your first love, your mm-hmm. first thoughts about what you want to do with your life, your first serious thoughts, I should say, because certainly mm-hmm. younger kids are saying, I'm going to be a fireman when I grow up, or that kind of thing. But in those teen years, that's when it's like, wait, I really do have to make a decision about this. It's not just some fantasy out there. I have to decide, what do I want to do with my life? And those are things that are such vivid choices and vivid decisions that it's really interesting to write about kids at that stage of life.
And I imagine that maybe makes it more fun. Sometimes adults get a little cynical and old weary and kind of think, not going anywhere. Instead of here, you got optimism and you're looking forward to the future.
Well, hopefully. I mean, there are certainly teenagers who don't feel particularly optimistic, but I always feel like there's still hope for kids, even if they're being very cynical and down on things. A lot of times with adults, you know, you want to believe that there's always hope for them, but maybe not.
Tell us a little bit about the Missing series. This is the first book in the series that
That's
we have
correct.
Here found. What is happening here?
I'll admit it's a very strange book.
Okay.
It begins with an airplane landing at an airport in the Midwest, where
oh,
it is not supposed to be. And of course, everybody at the airport is very upset that this plane has landed out of the blue, and they try to get in touch with the pilot. No answer. Finally, somebody from the airport just walks onto that plane, looks around, discovers there's no pilot, there's no crew, there's not a single adult on the entire plane. There are just 36 babies. And then the whole rest of the series is basically mm-hmm. revealing who those babies are.
Did you start out with that image in your mind, or did you have something else
that
you went back to?
I did. That was actually the first part of the whole series that came to me, and I went through that struggle of, wait, now I need to figure out who those babies are before I can actually write this book and the rest of the series.
You mentioned young adult fiction when you were young. I'm wondering if young adult fiction has changed.
Oh, I think definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely. I'm old enough. It was a long time ago that I was a teenager. And I think that when I was, you know, high school age, certainly the expectation was by that point, everybody was reading adult books. Mm-hmm. That, you know, there was some what was categorized as young adult fiction, but it was mainly, there wasn't the burgeoning group of books that there is now. I mean, I think we're almost in a golden age of young adult fiction right now.
So is it more like, okay, there's the books for kids, books for adults, and then there's that ages from, say, 10 to 18, there's nothing for them, that's the way it used to be?
Well, I think there was kind of the expectation that you would jump from, mm-hmm. you know, like the Hardy Boys to reading, I don't know, Moby Dick, practically. Uh-huh. There was a little bit more in between, but not a whole lot.
Is part of the appeal that the characters are the same age?
Definitely.
In a series, I'm thinking of like my nieces and nephews that are that age. They just plow through those books.
Right.
Whether it's your series or another series, it's like they can't get enough. And I say, well, what do you want for Christmas? And
they want the next book. Yes.
And they want, yeah. yeah.
And that's obviously kind of the hope when you're writing a series. You want people to have that reaction. The sixth book in this series, which is called Risk, just came out a couple weeks ago. And it's very funny. I've already had people contacting me and saying, okay, when's the next one coming out? And it's not for another year. Yeah. So I feel very bad saying to them, no, you can't have that one yet.
It's almost like it seems like they should wait until you have the whole series done before you read them.
I don't think the publisher wants to kind of put off their profits that long.
What is your relationship with your young readers?
I visit a lot of schools. I do a lot of like book festivals and things like this where I have interaction with my fans, and that's very nice to hear from them directly about what they like, or in some cases what they don't mm-hmm. like. And that's very nice for me to hear, not only to hear them say, I really like what you wrote, but also kind of hear their perspective on things. And it makes it easier for me to write from a kid's perspective that I'm hearing from a lot of kids.
Do they ever help you by saying things like, well, no one I know would behave that way. No one my age would do that. Does that ever pop up? Or do you think you've got that
down by now? But I will tell you that... this is something that is different with the series than with standalone books that I've done, because I've done a lot of those as well. I have had kids say, I want to know more about this character, or I think this should happen. And with a series, because I'm writing it over the course of several years, I can say, you know what, I'll bring that character back and I will give you more information about him.
So there may be characters that you thought weren't that important that maybe really resonated with the kids.
Exactly. That has happened.
Well, you're here at the South Dakota Festival of Books. You've said you've been to other book festivals. Mm-hmm. This is the first time here. What is it that you like about book festivals, or what do you get out of this experience?
Well, it's always fun to meet other authors that I may or may not know. So it's fun for me to go to the sessions just like it is for anybody who enjoys reading books. And it's also fun to see the variety of people who come out, the people who are very passionate about books. That's always nice to see.
Well, thanks so much for stopping by. Hope you enjoy the rest of your time here in Deadwood. We're talking with Margaret Peterson Haddix, author of The Missing series. Thanks so much.
Okay, thank you.
Writer's Rendezvous is a production of SDPB.